It's the Gear Tester here, and welcome to my full-length review of the Swan Dry Bush Shirt. This is a very unique garment, and when I saw it in a local sporting goods store, I had to purchase it. I had to purchase it because it was so unique, so almost strange, and I wanted to see what it was like to wear this. I wanted to see how warm it was. I wanted to see how effective it was. This is a very, very unique garment. It's 100% wool. It's made in New Zealand. And a fun fact about me, I lived for a year in Australia in my 20s. When I saw that there was something that was made near Australia in New Zealand, I thought that's really cool. I happen to like wool clothing, natural fiber clothing. I really like modern nylon clothing as well, but there's something about having traditional fabric, having fabric that is made from animal fibers that I really like. So 100% wool, made in New Zealand. One of the things that's unique about it is how far down it comes on the leg and the fact that it doesn't have any opening here on the front. So you've got to pull it on over. And that's a very kind of unique feature. And it's made me reevaluate why ancient people wore the items that they did. For instance, belts with gear and equipment on the outside. One of the things I like about this Swan Dry garment is the fact that it comes down further than most of the clothing I own. Okay, so this is a different style. This is a style of garment from 100 years ago. And so at least in the United States where I've grown up, we don't wear garments that come down this long in the back and the front traditionally, especially if they don't have some kind of way to open the garment up like a jacket. Pulling this over complicates things, but it also has some benefits. So you've got more coverage, particularly as you can see, I'm out here in the wintry conditions. I really like having an additional layer of insulation on my backside, okay, coming down further than a normal jacket would for me. I really appreciate and like that. In addition, when I go to sit down, this garment provides an additional layer of padding and insulation between me and the ground. Now, I don't do that a lot, but it is nice to have it there. But that complicates things. It's harder to access the areas that I would normally carry gear and equipment on my person. For instance, my belt line. Okay, so having a knife or other item here on my belt in this area makes it, you gotta kinda lift this garment up and fight it to get it out. Whereas normally, other jackets and items are just shorter and I've got less to have to deal with. So, you might find it useful to have some kind of a little belt with some accoutrements on it. You can see here I've just got this over belt with a little pouch and then a place for my hatchet or axe there, the Gibson carving axe. So I'm able to throw this around my waist like so and access items off the belt that's now on the outside of this garment rather than trying to hike my, in essence, my skirt up and access other items. They have a little cut here and a little kind of gusset right there, and that actually allows me to easily access things in my pants pockets, my front pants pockets, and that's very useful. But you just need to be aware that when you go with a garment like this, it's gonna kind of change the way you operate. It's not easy to get in and out of this. You gotta pull it up and over like a big hoodie, and that's fine, but you're gonna need to find additional ways to access gear and equipment when you're out and about with this garment on. And in fact, I sometimes get teased by my friends when I choose to wear this when I'm doing things like camping or out ice fishing. They think it's a little bit funny. One of the best jokes that I've heard here recently is one of my friends came walking up as we were headed out having finished ice fishing, and he said, "Hey, where's Sacagawea?" Because this does kind of look like the garments that Lewis and Clark wore as they engage in their journey of exploration across the United States. So I get that the coloration is kind of bright and out there. It's long, and because I'm a very short, compact guy, if I put the hood up, I look a lot like a little garden gnome. So I get that. I have adorned my Swan Dry Bush Shirt here with a little bead that I made from a deer antler. And I think that that's kind of in keeping with the kind of more traditional ancient look of this garment. It's got closures, or it's got some straps that allow you to close the sleeves up a little bit more here. It has buttons and this pull cord here to close the jacket up around your neck and throat. And it has this one little pocket which fits an iPhone perfectly, if you're wondering. Right here, a little breast pocket. And I think that that's useful. I just want to provide a little close-up look at the Swan Dry men's bush shirt. just let you look at it up more closely here. The stitching is just excellent here. You do have a liner, and so you've got a liner in the hood down to the first third of your core. So it's not in the sleeves. The sleeves don't have that green liner. It looks to me like sometimes they use a black liner as well, or a gray liner, depending on the coloration you have, and you don't have the liner here. So the liner comes down to right below, just an inch or two below where the cut in the collar ends. Right, so the stitching's excellent. You can get this in three different colorations. The men's bush shirt that's got the lace-up neck currently, you can get it in a black and red, just like this one. You can get it in a blue and black, just like this one, but of course, where it's red, it would be blue. And then you can get it in a solid olive drab green coloration. So I just think this thing is a very interesting, unique garment, and I've really enjoyed using it and will continue to use it. If you like this video, I would encourage you to subscribe to my channel for more quality video reviews on the topics of shooting, camping, and survival gear. I've created a new playlist called Clothing Reviews on my YouTube channel, and you'll be able to go there to see other garments, other items of clothing that I have reviewed over the last couple years, and as I continue to add to that group of reviews. Thank you very much for your views and your subscriptions. If you like this video, I would encourage you to subscribe to my channel. Make sure to click the notification bell so you'll be made aware when I produce other reviews on quality gear and equipment. Thank you very much for your views and your subscriptions. This is the Gear Tester signing off.